So good afternoon, students. So last class we discussed about reduction procedure. Reduction procedure. In today class we are going to discuss about applications. Okay, in previous class we discussed about reduction procedure. In today class we are going to discuss about applications. So what is the reduction algorithm? What we discussed in our previous class, there are some steps you are going to follow. In that, so three are the initialization steps. Initialization steps. Step one, steps step 2, step 3. So these are the initialization steps. So the first step is, so combine all serial links by multiplying their path expressions. So next, combine all parallel links by adding their path expressions. And third one, remove all self loops replacing with link of form of x star. So remove all self loops, replace with links of the form x star. Now, so these are the initialization steps. So after that, you are going to run a loop. In this loop, you are going to select a node that may not be starting entry node and exit node. Okay. So after that, you are going to apply. Just wait. So after that, you are going to apply again step 1, step 2, step 3. The step one is combine any serial links, combine any parallel links, and remove self loops. Okay, and after completion of these three steps, you are going to check that the entry and exit node. So for example, this is the entry and this is the exit. And now you can check that, is there only one node between these two nodes? Then you stop the reduction algorithm. Okay, so this is the reduction algorithm. The first three steps, 1, 2, 3. So these are the initializations. What is the first step? This is regarding, so combine serial links. Combine serial links. Second step, combine any parallel links. So combine parallel links. So third one, remove self loops. Remove self loops. And what is the fourth step? The fourth step is select a node. Select a node between the entry and exit nodes. So between entry and exit nodes. Okay. So after that, so for that node, you are going to again apply the 5, 6, 7 steps. What's the fifth step? The fifth step is again combine the serial links. The sixth step is combine the process links, parallel links. And seventh one, so remove self loops. And the eighth step, in eighth step, you are going to check, is there just one node? Is there only one node between the entry and exit node? If there is only one node, you can stop the process. If there is more than one node, for example, so this is the node, another node, 4. Now you are going to apply again the step 4. Okay, so this is the reduction algorithm. So what we discussed in our previous class. In today class, we are going to discuss about applications. The node reduction removal algorithm have several applications. Okay. And for every application, a common pattern or common procedure to be followed. The node reduction removal algorithm, so what we discussed in our previous class, has several applications. And for every application, a common pattern or common procedure we are going to follow. What is the common pattern you are going to follow? The first one, each and every graph should be converted to path expression. So path expression. So that means this is the node 1, node 3, node 6. So these have some links A, B. Now, so what is the first step? So each and every graph. So this is the flow graph. This is the flow graph. Now, each and every graph should be converted to path expression. Now, this is converted as a path expression A, B. A, B. Okay. What is the next step? The set of arithmetic rules must be derived for the selected property of the paths. Now, you are going to derive some arithmetic rules. Now, we are going to discuss. So, these rules must be derived for the selected property of the paths. And next step, the link name should be replaced by link weights. Link names should be replaced by link weights. That means for A, we are going to give the weight 3. For 4, we are going to give the weight 4. Now we are going to replace these link names with link weights. For example, 3, 4. Okay. Next, so that the path expression will be converted into some algebraic expression. Okay, now the path expression AB will be converted into some algebraic expression 3, 4. Okay, so coming to applications, the node reduction removal algorithm have some several applications, and every application we are going to follow a common pattern. The common pattern means in the first one, convert the program or graph into a path expression. Second, identify a property of interest and derive an appropriate set of arithmetic rules that characterize the property. And third one, so replace the link names by the link weights for the for the property of interest. The path expression has now been converted to an expression in some algebra, such as ordinary algebra and regular expressions or Boolean algebra. And finally, so simplify or equivalent the result algebraic expression to answer the question. So that means what is the weights? Here we are going to provide the weights. So now, so after completion of this path reduction algorithm, you are going to get some value. That means you are simplifying this algebraic expression, you get some answer. Okay, now we see the list of applications include as follows. The list of applications includes as follows. The first one is maximum path count arithmetic, structured code, lower path count arithmetic, so probability of being at a certain point, so mean processing time of routine, so push pop get return problem solving. Okay, so first one, so maximum path count arithmetic. Here, the most important application of node removal algorithm is to find the maximum number of paths in the graph. For this, each and every link in the graph has to be assigned a weight. So assigned a weight. And at loops, it has to be numbered with the digit which gives the maximum number of times the loop can be taken. If the count of the loop is infinite, then the maximum path count would be infinite and the process can be stopped. Okay, so what it means? For example, so this is the node 1, node 2, node 3. Okay, now this is the flow graph. Let us assume this is the flow graph A, B. Now these links are associated with the weight. The most important application of node removal algorithm is to find the maximum number of paths in the graph. How many paths are in the graph? So how many paths in the graph? How we can know means by reducing the paths with the help of path reducing algorithm. Now, Here we are going to find the maximum number of paths in the graph. So how we can find means each link is associated or assigned with some weight. Here the link A. Now this A is associated like this, for example 3. Okay, now at the loops, if there is any loops, for example this is the loop, or so this is the self loop, and at the loop it has to be numbered with the digit which gives the maximum number of times the loop can be taken. So for example I give 4. Now this loop can take 4 times. The count of the loop is infinite, then the maximum path count would be infinite. If it is infinitely executing, then we say that it is infinitely executing. So that means we say that the path count would be also infinite. Why? It is infinitely executing the same instruction. So we say that it is, the paths are infinite. Okay, so now the process can be stopped. Okay, so these are the arithmetic rules. The three arithmetic rules that are to be, just wait. The three arithmetic rules that are to be followed in reduction. Okay, so reduction is nothing but you are reducing the links. So one is parallel loop, parallel rule, series rule, and loop rule. So this is the loop rule. So the values that should be considered in case of series, parallel, and loop cases are, so this is the path expression A plus B. So this is the series AB. So loop A power N. What it means? So for example, so this is the nodes. Okay, so these are the series. So for example, this is the A, B. Then we write this as a A, B. A, B. Okay, so this can be expressed with some weights. So W, A and W, B. So we can write like this. The weight expression is W, A into W, B. Okay, so this is the series rule. Now, parallel rule. So parallel is nothing but this is the parallel. So these two are the parallel. Then you can express that weight as W A plus W B. If it is the series, then you can express as W A into W B. And the loop is expressed as the weight of A. So that means A of I. Now, I, for example, the loop executes 3 times, then it is A power 3. If the loop executes 10 times, then it is A power 10. Okay. The three arithmetic rules that are to be followed in reduction are parallel rule, series rule, loop rule. The values that should be considered in case of series, parallel, and loop cases are, so this is the path expression A plus B. For that, so this is the weight W A plus W B. So this is the series expression A B. For that, this is the path W A into W B. So similarly, this is the A power N is the loop. For that, the weight expression is sigma I equals to 0 to N W W A. Okay, so sigma I equals to 0 to N and so W A I. Okay, so these are the arithmetic rules. So coming to parallel rule. Parallel rule. The parallel rule is explained as the term in first expression summed up with each term in the second expression. If the weights of the links are WA and WB, then the result is WA plus WB. So this is the example. So node 1, 3, 4, 5. Okay. If you observe, these are the parallel paths. So 3 to 4, again same, 3 to 4. This is the one, this is the second one. Now, so this is the parallel path. So you can apply the parallel rule and the weights is 0.1, 0.05. So WA plus WB, now it becomes 0.1 plus 0.05. Now it becomes 0.15. Okay, so this is the parallel rule. Series rule. So what is the series rule? Each term in path expression is concatenated or multiplied with each term in second path expression. If WA and WB are weights, then the result is WA into WB. Okay. Now, so this is the example. So these are the nodes 1, 3, 4, 5, 2. So this is the entry node. This is the exit node. 2 is the exit node. Now, if you observe that, so these are the series rule, series of paths. Okay. Now, you can combine this like this 3, 4, 5. Instead of this, you are going to write 1 and 3. And 2. And what is the weight here? So what is the weight here? Here the weight is multiplication of these two weights, 0.1 into 0.2. So it becomes 0.02. So here we are going to give the weight is 0.02. Okay. So this is the series rule. So next, loop rule. So next one is loop rule. The loop rule is considered the number of times the path repeated. Here, so this is the loop. If you observe that, so this is the loop. Here, we move to the fourth node. Again, we move to the third node. Again, fourth node, third node. So this we are called as a loop. Okay. So what is the loop expression? Sigma I equals to 0 to n, so WA of I. Okay, now here two nodes. So the weight is 1 into 1. And you can apply this for sigma I equals to 0 to 2. So we got 1 power 0, 1 power 1. 1 power 2, 1 plus 1 plus 1, it is 3. Okay, now the weight is changed like this, 3. Okay, here 0 to 2 means 2 times executing the loop. So this is about loop rule. Okay, now we are taking one example. So this is the graph. So this is the flow graph. It consists of parallel paths, series paths, and loop paths, inner loop paths. Now, you are going to find the number of paths in this graph. How many number of paths are there in this graph? So, what is the first step? The first step is you are going to give the weights for links. What is the common procedure? You are going to convert the program or graph into a path expression and you are going to give the weights to all the links. Okay.
So here A, B, C, D, E, K, M, L, J, F, G, H. All these are the links. Now you are going to give weights to all these links. Okay. So these are the weights. Here, all single links are assigned weight 1. So 1. All weights are initialized with, assigned with number 1. So 4 to 4 means, so 4 times it executes. 3 times it executes. So this is the loop. Okay. Assigning weights to each link. Next step. All parallel loops. The next step is, all parallel loops are reduced by applying parallel rule. So what is the parallel rule? If there is any loops parallelly, if there is any paths parallelly, if you see this diagram, in this, so these two are the parallel. It is also moves like this. So this is also like this. That means, so these two are the parallel. So you can write like this. You connect with, and you can write the weight as a 2. Okay. Similarly here. So this is also parallel. From this node, you move to in this direction. And similarly, this is also same direction. So here also you are going to write like this. These two nodes are connected with 2. Okay. Now the diagrams change like this. Okay, so this is the 2 and this is the 2. Okay, this is serial links are combined. Just wait. All parallel loops are reduced by applying parallel rule. Now it changes like this. If you observe that the weights are changed to 2. Why? The formula is, so WA plus WB here. Okay. So next, series. Is there any serial links? Serial links are combined by applying series rule. Okay, if there is any serial links, how we can identify that? If you see this diagram, so there is a serial link. If you see this, these are the serial links. From 1, we are moving like this up to here. So these are the serial links. Okay, now after applying the series rule, the diagram changes like this. Applying series rule to the above flow graph, then it changes like this. So after that series rule, you are going to apply the loop. Here we are taking the inner loop. For inner loop also, you are going to combine the serial links, and if there is any parallel links, you can apply all these steps. And so for this, reducing the inner loop, it seems like this. The weights are like this. So these are the 3. So sigma I equals to 0 to 3. So it is 1 power 0, 1 power 1, 1 power 2, 1 power 3. Okay. Now, if you apply this, you got the flow diagram like this. After that, so combining serial links, we got this. Here the serial links, if you observe that there is any serial links, so these are the serial links we have now. So that is changed like this. So 2, 4, 1. Okay, so these are the serial links. It changed after combining the serial links, the flow graphs like this. After applying the cross term step to create self loop, so this is the loop here. Okay, so this is the loop. Now, so this is the, after creating the self loop. and reducing the self loop, it seems like this. So 2 into 8 power 4 into 4. Now the value of this, so how many paths? So 3 to 7 6 8 paths, and this is the reduced flow graph. So this is the reduced flow graph for this graph. Okay, so this graph is changed like this, and the path, the number of paths are 3 to 7 6 8, and so this is the alternate way to calculate maximum number of paths is by substituting corresponding weights of each link in the path expression, which is, this is the path expression. So A into B plus C into D, E F I into F G, J into M plus L into K, E F J into F G H. So this is the expression we got from the initial flow graph. So this is the initial flow graph. So if you convert this initial flow graph into path expression, then we got this expression, the first expression. Okay, this expression. Okay, now substitute the values. Now we got 3 to 7, 6, 8. Okay, so this is about applications of path reduction algorithm. I hope you all are understand path reduction algorithm and the applications. So thank you all. We meet in tomorrow class. So thank you.